Welcome to episode 12 of the Brock and Dawson podcast. Thank you for listening. Hit the intro, Doss. Boom!
I think I'm the only one hearing this right now.
Yeah, bro. Welcome to episode 12, you guys. The 12th episode of this fantastic podcast. 12th of probably, I don't know, like 1,000 something. Yeah. What's probably. Joe Rogan at? Like a billion? We're going to get up to there at some point in our time.
Our subscribers might catch up to our amount of podcasts at some point.
Yeah. That's the Kawhi. Have you ever seen the Kawhi Leonard laugh? You've never seen Kawhi Leonard laugh, dude?
I don't know. Maybe I have.
You definitely have, but I'm going to look it up anyways. How do you spell the guy's name?
It's probably one of those things that I know, but I don't know.
Oh, you got it.
Kawhi Leonard. I thought you said.
That's what I said.
I thought you said, like, Clyde.
That's the laugh I'm doing right now in my head.
Clyde Leonard.
That's the laugh I just did in my head, bro. Listen.
And what would you like people to know about you?
I'm a fun guy. obviously, I love the game of basketball. I mean, it's just more question you have to ask me in order for me to tell you about myself. I just can't give you a whole spiel. I don't even know where you're sitting at.
Hold on, replay that, dude. That was the most awkward thing I've ever seen in my life. Andrew's ramble didn't even make sense. Oh my gosh, did I not go back far enough? Gosh dang it, dude. Okay, replay. Go. Okay, replay.
I don't even know where you're sitting at.
That's great. Oh my gosh.
We gotta add that to the soundboard, dude. That's epic.
Yes, we do need to add that to the soundboard.
Yeah, that's the laugh I just did when you said that. Anyways, bro, welcome back, everybody. It's another episode. We got fellow comrade Davis Bracken in the building, dude, in the studio. What's up, bro?
Nothing much. Just here, hanging out.
We're just here having a silly good time, bro. And we got some, dude, we've got some freaking fire topics today. I'm not even going to lie to you, dude. There's some stuff in today's podcast that might change your life. So stay tuned. That's all I'm going to say, bro.
I don't even know if I'm ready for this.
I don't know if you are, dude. I've been rehearsing all day. When I was at work, I just kept talking to myself, like, what I was going to say. And so, you know what? It's going to be a good day, fellas.
I better not hear any stuttering, Brock.
I'm going to stutter, dude. I stutter so hard all the time, and I mix up my words because my brain goes way too fast, and I can't talk.
My brain lags. Like, my brain has
That's what that's mine does.
It's literally what I do, dude. It's like I'm thinking at such a fast pace, and my mouth's just, like, trying to keep up and just says words that don't even make sense in the context, and that's... Dude, it's so hot, and I'm only wearing the sweatshirt with nothing under it, and it's so hot in here because all these lights are burning.
Just take it off. The viewers won't mind.
Take it off, dude.
Yeah.
I'm so ripped right now. Can I just say that, dude? I am jacked.
Welcome to the club, Brock.
I'm dude, just kidding. I weigh 160 right now, dude.
160? Dang. You're almost compared like, you're to almost
one,
where I'm at.
Compared to 195 in August, bro. I'm ripped as fudge. But anyways, bro, should we just get right into the topics, bro? Do you guys have anything you want to start off with? How you been living? How's life, bro? For both of you.
I mean, life is going pretty good. It took a little bit of a drop yesterday.
Dawson's having a little bit of personal problems. We don't need to get into
it. Yeah, we're not going to go into it.
It's personal, but hey, dude, that's why we're here. We're here to have a silly goose time, and that's all it is, man. What have you been up to?
Oh, jeez.
I haven't really been up to much, just working. That's all I do, work and...
That's dope, dude. Hey, wait.
Work hard, play hard.
I saw your video. I saw your TikTok video where you busted the thing over your thigh. Your dad showed me that. So, what's the trend even? I don't even know what that is.
I don't know. I just saw it. It said how to, like, break out of zip ties. Like,
yeah.
Without, like, cutting them or anything. You just break them over your leg.
So that sounds painful.
So, he's trying to break the zip ties over his leg, bro. Just picture this. He's got zip ties on his hand. And he's about to just snap them over his thigh. And his dad cut him a little more so it would be way too easy to break. And so he just smacked it over his thigh and also hit himself right in the testicles in the process. I started crying laughing, dude. It was so funny.
That didn't feel good at all.
Your dad's an epic prankster, bro. I mean, straight up. Oh, dude.
He probably just has a YouTube channel, like, pranking my son.
He's probably...
no one knows about it.
What's that show, Impractical... Prankers?
Impractical Jokers.
Impractical Jokers, dude. Yeah, he's secretly the the puppet master of that show. Oh, my gosh. Straight up. Oh, jeez, bro. I love that
show.
I've never even seen it. Is that that dude? What's that guy's name? Ron Atwood? What?
I'm just saying all the guys. I don't know.
Isn't there a guy named, like, Ron Atwood or something?
And I don't think so.
Oh, never mind. Dude, I'm making people up, bro. There's no, the person does not exist. Okay, dude. Should we get into my first topic, bro? This is what I've been rehearsing.
Yeah, let's get into it.
I wish I could walk around the room while I do this. I'm so full of energy right now, bro.
And do you want to take Davis's mic and just take a stroll?
Dude, actually might. But
Just go stand right in front of the camera and just start talking.
Here, you can use mine.
So, dude, essentially, dude. So, did you guys see, like, the, there was, like, a petition, because you know how spring sports have been canceled, bro?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, hold on, I want to be on the camera, because I'm so narcissistic. I'm so narcissistic, it's crazy. So, like, you know how there was the spring sports petition, dude? Is like, so spring sports got canceled, you know? Like, you both did spring sports, and...
I mean, they're not, like, 100% canceled for sure, but basically... Well, basically,
baseball... Yeah.
Baseball's basically done.
Yeah, that's what I heard. But anyways, so I'm on Instagram, bro, and I see these people, and they're posting, they were like, sign this petition for spring sports to be revamped. And I was just like, hey, dude, we're in the middle of a pandemic. Okay, dude? Hey, dude. Hey, guys and girls from my school and surrounding schools that posted that, we're in the middle of a pandemic. We're in a pandemic right now, dude. People are dying.
And signing a petition is not going to do anything.
Signing a petition. Oh, my gosh. That, first of all, dude, signing petition, not going to do a thing, dude. Do you think Governor Herbert is looking at your Instagram? And he's like, oh, man, these kids want to play their softball, man. We got to throw them back and throw them a bone at them, dude. No, dude. Petition? Nothing. Name one petition that's ever done anything. One. Have you ever seen a petition where it actually went somewhere? That's my question. Exactly, dude. So, number one, petitions don't help. And number two... We're in the middle of a pandemic, and you're trying to get people to sign your petition.
Take a drink every time Brock says we're in a pandemic.
Play spring sports.
Dude, you're going to be wasted by the end of this.
Spring sports, bro. A pandemic. Coronavirus, dude. COVID-19 is killing people. Do you understand, dude? You think they're just going to be like, oh, man, these kids want to play their sports. Let's throw them in the fire, bro. Let's throw them right in the crossfire. This pandemic. Gosh dang, bro. I don't understand, dude.
You're going to stand up and that chair is going to go out.
I get so heated, dude. And my sweatshirt's so hot. What's up?
The only thing I can respect about anything that was happening, there was one redshirt corona year. It's just for college athletes who missed their spring sports because they were just redshirting. Yeah. Which, NCAA, they made it so if you missed your spring sports season, you can apply for eligibility your next year. But other than that, like, high school sports, yeah, it sucks for seniors and everything, but, like, some people were saying, let's do our season in June.
Yeah.
That is summertime.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, dude. I get it. Like, for seniors, that sucks, man. Hey, that's trash. If you're a senior and you had a promising year ahead of you and it got canceled, that's trash, bro. But again, pandemic. Pandemic, okay?
I feel like this is just getting back at the seniors because they were always, like, bragging about how their class is the class of 2020. It's the best class ever. And so now it's getting back at them because now they don't even, like, get graduation or anything.
Yeah, guys, look at you now. Look at you go now, dude.
Now nobody wants to be part of your class.
Nothing! You have nothing. Anyways, that's what
2022 is the alpha.
That's all I gotta say.
2021. Hey, listen, consecutive integers.
2020, 2021, and 2022. Those are golden years, bro. Everything after that, you're just hoes.
You're
dude.
Just trash.
TikTok has destroyed your brains, and it's just gonna.
Your brains
gonna
are
die.
Mush.
You're gonna die, and you're gonna get addicted to vaping, and you're gonna die, and that's the that's the blunt reality that you have to face, dude. Anyways, petition, bro. That's trash. What was I going to say? I had such a funny thing to say, dude.
Petition to stop petitions.
Oh, yeah, dude. I'm going to start a petition to stop all petitions forever, dude. We'll see how that goes. We'll see how far that goes,
dude. Let's do it right now.
We'll go to change.org straight up, homie. Oh, my gosh. Change.org. Hey, dude, sign my petition to end petitions, dude. That's... Oh, man. Oh, dude. Oh, no, I remember what I was going to say. So, I feel like... The people that reposted this on their story, this is what happened when the people reposted that on the story. They woke up, and they just felt this void in their life, and they were like, man, my life's kind of awful. Something's missing. And they were like, I just got to do something today, bro. I got to get up. I got to do something. I'm going to do something for a change. I'm going to change my life.
So let's start a petition.
So they get on Instagram, bro, and they see that this petition is going around, and they repost it. And they're like, all right, I'm done. I'm done for the day. And then they binge Vampire Diaries for the rest of the day. And that's all they do. And my recording stopped. And my recording stopped, dude.
Screw this crap.
I don't get it, bro. I don't get... Dude, hey, BS for a second, bro.
BS for a second? Yeah, BS for a second. The coronavirus is made by the Democrats. That's that's the big thing going on in Facebook. If you look at, like, the... Facebook stuff going on right now. There's some crazy people in Enterprise who literally, there's so many conspiracy theories. Like, Enterprise Concerned Citizens is just the next conspiracy. Like, just, they're the makers of all conspiracies, I feel like. It's seriously ridiculous. I love going on there. There's one thing, I shouldn't put it in the podcast. Like, it's hilarious.
My gosh. You don't have to say names.
He had, you know, those things over in the new subdivision, like the little green guys that have the flag and it says slow on them. It says slow on them. Say okay, but yeah, someone like was on Enterprise Concerned Citizens saying everybody was like stealing those, and then Skyler posted he posted a video of he's like, man, these guys have just gone out of control. They're going all over Enterprise, and it was somebody driving a car with that thing in front of them. So that's all you could see is it sped by. Was that little guy? And all the people were getting pissed at him in the comments, and I was dying. It was the best thing I've ever seen.
People were getting mad.
Oh yeah, like they were going to report it to the police. Mad, and. Yeah, it was ridiculous, but man, respect, dude.
Recording's
respect.
Back live, bro. Recording's back live. I got to clap, bro. Hey, I got to do a clap.
Okay, we're back. We're back, dude. We're back with the video feed. Sorry for you that watch it. Dude, I feel like a lot more people watch the podcast than ever listen to it in their lives, dude. Honestly. Mm-hmm. I think videoing it has made a tremendous impact. What was next on my notes, dude? I'm going a million miles. Oh, dude, Trump's tweet. Did you ever see Trump's tweet that he said?
I don't think so.
It was just barely. And then I wrote it down in my notes. I wrote down in my notes. And then after I wrote it down in my notes, like three different podcasts came out and they all talked about it and it made me really upset. Anyways, bro. So this is legitimately what the President of the United States tweeted a couple of days ago. It's in quotations, so it's a quote apparently. President Trump is a ratings hit. Since reviving the daily White House briefing, Mr. Trump and his coronavirus updates have attracted an average audience of 8.5 million on cable news, roughly the viewership of the season finale of The Bachelor. Numbers are continuing to rise.
Hold up. What?
Hey, dude! Hey, dude! Dude, I literally retweeted it, and I was like, hey, dude, is this a real thing you just said, dude? The President of the United States... Oh, might I say again, during a pandemic? Oh, dude. No, that's actually not what it is. That's not what that's for. That's for triumphant things, bro.
Okay.
This is triumphant. That's like Bender. Have you ever seen Breakfast Club?
I have not.
At the end of Breakfast Club, there's this dude named John Bender, and he's on the football field, and he does this, and the eight fist pumps there, and he goes like this. The song plays, so it's like a triumphant. So
okay,
Donald
well, back
Trump,
to that. Back to that, yeah.
So Donald Trump, bro, he's out here during a pandemic. He's out here bragging about his freaking audience, his freaking ratings that he's attracted because of the pandemic, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Straight up because of the pandemic. And he's like, I had the best ratings of any president of all time. I am more popular than The Bachelor because of this pandemic. We have attracted 8.5 million ratings on Spotify. And it's like, dude, hey. Dude, imagine Woodrow Wilson during the 1918 influenza virus, and he's just like, guys, my ratings are up, all right? I know 500,000 of you have died, but the ratings are up, and I'm beating all the liberal news outlets, so what's the problem here, dude? Oh my gosh. Can we just sit back, dude? Just sit back and reflect on that the president of the United States literally said that. And he related himself to the season finale of The Bachelor during the pandemic, dude. Let's just reflect.
Can you're not wasted already.
Oh my gosh. That's why you need a little more careful there, Brock.
Dude.
But yeah, that's kind of really dumb because he's literally just saying people are going to watch it because they want to know what's going on with the coronavirus. Yeah, exactly. And that's where you get your updates is from the White House when there's a national emergency going on. So obviously people are going to watch it, but that doesn't mean your ratings are up. It's because people are going to watch it because they want to see the news on a national emergency.
The numbers are continuing to rise. Dude, that's so funny. As more and more people
die. I really want to respond to that and say, yeah, the numbers are continuing to rise of people infected too, you idiot.
Dude, he's so... Oh, dude, I'm not one of these people that's like a Trump basher. I'm not a pro-Trump guy. I'm not an anti-Trump guy. I think he's smart in some ways, but he's really dumb in other ways. And
I think he should just be banned from Twitter, and that would make him
five times greater president. No, that's the best part of this presidency, dude.
But he's an idiot on Twitter. He is an idiot on Twitter, just like we saw right there.
He's giving us glorious content,
That's true. During this quarantine, it is nice to have some content like this.
And he kept going, dude. There's like 50 tweets under it. He just continues in this thread, but that's so funny, dude. That's so funny.
I want to see if they make like a Trump channel because of that, because I think the ratings will be super high. He has his own channel.
Oh, dude.
And it's like reality. It's like reality TV in the White House.
Bro, he's literally a reality TV star. That's
no, but like so in the White House, though, that reality TV. That would be pretty interesting.
I'm going to call this right now. Reality TV show about the White House, not far from
keeping up.
It's
with
not
Donald
out of the
Trump.
Realm of possibilities,
keeping up with
people.
The Trumps, bro.
Oh my gosh!
Oh my gosh, dude! And dude,
we should
the
petition for that, bro.
Dude, petition. Okay, dude. This is podcast title. Sign my petition for keeping it real with. I don't even know what I was gonna
keeping
say.
Keeping real hey, with the Trumps. That
keeping up with the Trumps.
Dude, but the Kardashians will even be in it because Kanye and Trump and Kim are all like they're like this tight little group. So that'd be.
Dude, that'd be a crossover.
Dude, like Jimmy Neutron and freaking Fairly OddParents, bro. You ever watch that? That's the most legendary crossover episode of all time, dude. And then Timmy Turner was like animated like Jimmy Neutron, and Jimmy Neutron was animated like Timmy Turner, and it was really awkward, dude. That was some of the most unsettling things in my childhood. Like, that's not natural. But all of a sudden, it was a thing in my life, and I was like, all right, dude. So, yeah. That's so funny. That's so funny, bro. Trump, man.
Man, that's something there.
What a guy.
Trump. Dude, oh my gosh. All politicians. Hey, who's funnier, Trump or Biden, dude?
Are you kidding me?
Seen
Biden? It's Trump.
No, but dude.
Biden thinks he's funnier to little girls.
No, but dude. Okay, dude. I'm going to turn my microphone off because I'm just going to slam it.
It's still on.
Oh,
you
shit,
didn't turn it off. I'm sorry, viewers. Brock, you're going to have to put in a headphone warning right there because that was kind of loud.
I'll just fix it in post.
Just fix it in post, I...
Okay, let's see if this is the actual video.
Is Biden actually, like, funny? Because I don't
know. No, he's not intentionally funny, dude.
He's one of those guys.
He's genuinely senile. Okay, let's see if I can actually find the literal video or if it's just going to be a person freaking talking over it because that pisses me off.
It's New York Times, so it probably will be them talking over it.
Sucks so bad, dude.
They're going to want you to subscribe first before you can watch the video.
Yeah, that sucks, and dude. I hate the New York Times.
Because we should challenge these students.
Oh, yes.
We should challenge students in these schools to have advanced placement programs in these schools. We have this notion that somehow if you're poor, you cannot do it. Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids. Wealthy kids, black kids, Asian kids.
Oh!
Dude. No, dude.
Dude, come on, dude. That's dude, so you're trying to go against that's discrimination, so and then poor kids are just as good as white
that's
kids.
That's so funny, dude.
White kids. Wealthy kids, black kids.
He tried to save it.
To that recovery, bro.
Wealthy kids, black kids, Asian kids.
He just starts listing everything. Bisexual kids.
Poor.
Kids,
you
kids
cannot do
towns.
It. Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
This is the moment when Biden.
Wealthy kids, black kids, Asian kids. No, I really mean it, but think how we think about
Asian
it.
Asian kids. Gay kids.
Dude, just, that's you know, so that is funny. A little loud also.
Oh
I'm,
my
I'm
gosh,
sorry.
Dude. That is so
I felt the embarrassment.
Bernie Sanders. No, we don't need to see any we don't need to feel so, the burn right now.
That is so funny, dude. Come on. Is that not the dude? Oh man, if it comes down between Trump and Biden, bro. Why is it all these old dudes?
Well, it's just going to end up both of them are going to be roasting Biden. Both of them will be.
Yeah.
So that'll be fun to watch.
The left is pushing for Biden, I'm pretty sure. I don't know anything about
politics. Well, it's because
politics.
Bernie obviously would not win in a presidential election because the majority of people aren't going to choose a socialist. I mean, the majority of Democrats might, but not the majority of people. So that's why they're trying to get Biden in.
Dude, that's so funny. Well, I can't believe it's... Dude, what is the average age of all these presidential candidates?
I want to say it's like
die.
75 or
they're
something.
Die,
it's
dude.
It's ridiculous.
They're straight up going to die in office.
I actually want to look this up real quick.
We need to get some like fresh faces in there. We need
Let's see.
You to run for president.
Donald
bro.
Trump
Me?
Is
run for president.
Donald Trump
dude,
is 73.
Trump is so old, bro.
Joe Biden is the oldest of them all, I'm pretty sure. Joe Biden is 77.
Joe Biden is the oldest?
He's going Yeah,
he's
77.
Bernie needs to do something, dude. He needs to get some witch oil for his
Bernie
skin
is 78, actually. Okay, so Bernie's a year older. So,
but he looks 20 years older than that.
So if any Democrat gets elected, they will be like 83 years old by the time they're out of office.
Bro, they should not be alive, statistically speaking. They should not be alive right now.
Well, the coronavirus will make sure of that.
The coronavirus
yeah,
will
dude,
take
what
them
if
out.
Corona gets to one of them, dude?
The corona's going to get to all of them, probably, because it'll kill any of them. It's like, once you're 80 plus, I want to say the percentage, the death rate's like 25% or something for coronavirus.
Jeez, bro.
So, that means at least one of them's probably going to die if they all get it.
Was Obama the youngest president?
Well,
he looked the youngest.
Well, like, the youngest in modern times, maybe.
The youngest
president. I don't know.
Who,
like
the president who the president was during influenza.
Like I looked up who the president
if
was.
If Alexander Hamilton
so
would have actually been
joke,
president,
dude.
Then he would have been.
That's awesome. That's so awesome. Who is the youngest U.S. president? It was McKinley.
Theodore Roosevelt?
Wait. The youngest person to assume presidency was Theodore Roosevelt.
He was 42.
42 bro.
Wow.
Well, how old was Obama, dude? How old?
Well, I don't think Obama was that much older. It's just you have to be at least 35 to run.
Yeah. That's so. But if you look in the pictures, dude, it's all like old wrinkly guys, and it's like, why are you making decisions, bro? Some old people can't even go to the bathroom, and those are the people that freaking, they drive slow and they can't use technology, and they're making the decisions for our country, bro. Come on.
Yeah. Come on, I mean, I don't know if the young people are also that great of an option either. Yeah. Though there's some crazy.
Nobody is, dude. You they, gotta. You
I know. We need.
We need to go back in
some
time.
Fresh
we
new
need to
faces.
Go back. I don't even know, dude. I think politicians have been terrible people all the time forever.
Not forever. It started like early 1900s. That's when it started taking off. Or
dude,
probably before that, like no, the 1800s, like Tweed and all them.
I don't even know who that is, but...
Sorry, we learned about that in history.
But, like, those dudes freaking bought a president. The Rockefeller and them, back in the 1800s, they bought a president. McKinley, I'm pretty sure. I have no idea. I don't pay attention in school, but... what was I going to say? Gosh, dang it. Oh, yeah, dude, you just can't expect one person...
Yeah, I can't really hear you.
You can't there expect you one person to be put into power and, like, do a good job. You know what
mm-hmm.
I mean? Like, presidency is such a weird thing. Like, how do you even gauge that, bro?
You know, but then there's the problem. If you had five people as president, they're not going to be able to decide anything.
Yeah.
It's a weird. We gotta figure out how to fix this, bro.
Yeah.
It's not gonna be in our lifetime. Hopefully someday, though. Unless this coronavirus really is the end of the world, then we don't even have to worry about it, dude.
Okay, what about if Yellowstone, the volcano blows up?
Dude.
That'll take out half the U.S. Sick.
Bro, there's so many things we don't even think about. Freaking Rogan was talking about it. Just like if a meteor came and just obliterated us. Like it.
That'd
like
be pretty sick. I don't know.
Like this pandemic thing has not really happened in our lifetimes or even close to it. And we just like never really thought it would happen. And now it's happening. So like what else would... What else could happen, dude? Like, reality has just changed.
I mean, Donald Trump was elected president.
Yeah, dude, exactly.
So
Donald Trump was president. You know what's funny, though? I didn't know who Donald Trump was until he was president.
I didn't either.
And everyone's like, oh, he is just he was such a big celebrity. I'm like, I don't know who this dude was, dude.
Wasn't he, like, a celebrity in, like, the 90s?
I don't know. I guess, yeah. Like, 90s, early 2000s. He was in freaking... Home Alone 2 and Little Rascals.
He was in Home Alone 2?
Yeah, bro. Yeah, he's in the elevator,
dude.
Have
you seen the clip?
You not seen the clip? Should we pull that up?
I don't
Jamie?
Know if I have.
It's kind of like, it's like right when he walks into the...
He like walks into this elevator.
I don't know the last time I saw Home Alone 2. I saw number 1 this year, but I don't know the last time I saw number 2.
I got elevator from Home Alone. And he was, what's his bucket's dad in? Freaking, have you ever seen Little Rascals, dude?
Yeah.
Like
I haven't.
The original, the OG.
Nope.
Jump in Home Alone 2. Ready? Watch this, bro. That's Kevin McAllister. I'm sure you don't judge me.
Okay. Excuse me, where's the lobby?
Oh my god.
Down
goodness.
The hall into the
Donald
left.
Trump.
Thanks.
Donald Trump, baby, the man. Who,
oh my god.
Who would have thought, bro, that that man would be running our country, man, in... However many years that is. Oh, shoot, dude.
I have no clue how many years that is, but that's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. I'm not
It's not the first time we've had a TV star as president. I mean, Ronald Reagan was
Reagan
TV star.
Oh, yeah. Wait, what was that? I feel like I knew he was a TV star. What was he? What was he a celebrity for?
I don't remember. He was just an actor. I know that for a while. He was an actor.
Yeah, like as a kid, right?
I don't really know, honestly.
I don't know anything, dude. I'm probably one of the dumbest people on this planet, for sure. Like, top 10 rated dumbest people. Dude.
I don't know. There's...
Bro, that's a good segue, because we're about to start talking about Tiger King, dude.
Oh, my gosh.
Tiger King, bro. Have you heard about this?
I definitely don't think I know who he is.
My mom
dude.
Was watching
it. She was watching it? Dude, it's so legendary.
That's insane. I forgot that you sent me that, but then my mom was explaining it to me. I was like, what the freak is
oh,
this?
Oh, yes, my recording. Yes, dude, my recording stopped again.
Let's go!
Yes, dude!
Why is it stopping like every 15 minutes?
I don't know. It did this last time, too, and it was really making me upset, but it's okay, dude.
That's pretty dope, you know? I mean, I'm sure the viewers are loving this. They don't have to see our faces for a little while.
Yeah, man. Sure.
Make sure you clap. Make sure you clap.
Clap.
Did you clap on the last one?
Yeah.
On last okay, one. Good.
I even remembered, bro. So,
good.
Frick, what were we talking? Tiger King, bro. So, I actually knew this story before this even was thought of, this documentary series, because there's this YouTuber named Prim Inc, dude, and I got into him about a year ago, actually. And I watched his video. He made a video about this guy. Like basically a year ago, like 10 months ago, I think. And then this documentary came out and everybody like was talking about it. And I was like, actually I had some insider knowledge before. So that means I am cooler than you. But anyways, Tiger King, dude. So dude, if you have watched a show, if you're in quarantine right now, bro, and you have Netflix and need something to watch, Tiger King is your show, bro. If you're fine with language and all that. It's the most insane thing I've ever watched, and every single person in it, there's not one person that shows up on screen during the entire 7 episodes that is not absolutely at their core a horrible person and stupid, dude. Both of those things, they are both equally horrible and stupid if they are on screen in that show. I'm telling you that right now, bro. It's so funny to watch.
It sounds like something I need to watch, for sure.
Dude, everybody in it is just a redneck. Oh, my gosh. So, the main dude, Joe Exotic, right? He's the most redneck guy you could
Joe
ever.
Joe Exotic.
He had his name changed to Joe Exotic, bro. most redneck. He's this redneck freaking hillbilly from, I don't remember where it was from. He's a gay. He's a homosexual polygamist.
Homosexual polygamist.
He has two husbands.
I've never heard of that before.
Dude, it's so awesome, dude. This guy, okay. So he's a gay polygamist, bro.
And he's a redneck, too.
And he's a redneck. He has like 60 earrings in one ear, and he just has the coolest accent.
He sounds like the cool guy to be around.
He does. Sounds pretty chill.
What he looks like, bro? Let's just watch.
Is he pretty chill? Because it sounds like it.
Oh, yeah. He's so chill, dude.
Joe Exotic memes. Joe Exotic for president.
Well, he has a YouTube channel?
Dude, we'll get into that. Yeah, dude. Okay. You gotta watch this documentary, dude. You've got to watch this documentary, bro.
What is that?
I'm not even joking, dude. Joe Exotic, bro. So, he owns, like, a tiger sanctuary where... Because apparently he was just in love with, like, just exotic animals. And so he starts this tiger, like, basically a zoo, right? And it's starting to take off. But then there's, like, this other lady that's, like, a... She's, like, an animal rights enthusiast named Carol Baskin, dude. Hate Carol Baskin, dude. Straight up... Stone cold biatch, dude. I'm telling you what. Dude, she's the worst. And she's like one of these hippies that's like I don't... Dude, there's more tigers captive in America right now than there is in the rest of the world, bro. It's pull up the stats. There's like 5,000 to 10,000 tigers in the U.S. held captive. And there's 4,000 tigers in the wild in the rest of the world, bro.
What?
So it's like, I don't think tigers should be held captive either, but she's like... way overboard with this cat stuff, bro. She's like got a she's got like a tiger skin house, bro. It's
that's like against everything that she's believing in.
Yeah, what the freak?
Dude, and I know, and she has like a whole sanctuary with tigers in it. Like she has tigers in cages at her place, and she lets people walk through. And she's like apparently wants but cats to be free, and I'm like, dude, what are you talking about?
Isn't that like the definition of a hypocrite? Like
he says she's the biggest hypocrite in the show. I'm pretty sure. But it's like... Cue the curve, dude. We're getting the curve on there, too. We're getting curve on the freaking soundboard. That show's so funny. Anyways, so Joe Exotic, dude. Let me just hit the highlights right here. So, redneck, gay, polygamist, tiger sanctuary, ran for president, put out a hit to kill Carol Baskin. Allegedly, he's in prison right now for... For paying for murder, bro. dude, it's... Oh, okay,
this sounds like something when you're trying to just make the craziest thing you possibly can.
Exactly.
Like, it's like the... Like, redneck, that's pretty far out there. Gay polygamist. And he owns tigers.
Like, I'm pretty sure I wrote a story about this in fourth grade. For my language arts class.
It's something new, like... It's like a bad fever dream, and you just wake up, and you're like, what was that, dude? Look at it, look at what he's wearing, bro. He's got...
That looks like something you'd see when you're just on some crazy drug.
Dude, it's so awesome, bro. I don't even know what I was going to bring up about this, but it's the best show in the entire world. Gay polygamist, Carol Baskin, put out a hit. Oh, yeah, so basically, dude, he had two husbands at the start of the show, right? Oh, I got to pull up this guy, bro. I gotta pull up this husband, bro. I forgot his name. It might be like John or something. Joe Exotic.
Travis?
No, Chad. Actually, no. Oh, I was like, dude, that's actually one of the guy's name. I was like, oh my gosh. Where's John?
Just look up husbands.
Oh, man.
Plural.
Yeah, plural.
This is the man, bro. This is the dude. This is his husband, bro. This is one of his husbands. Oh. His name is John, dude. Bro, he was shirtless the entire time he was being interviewed. That's one of his husbands, man. So funny. And they're obviously... The funny thing is, dude, all the people he married, later they revealed that they were straight. Like, they were never gay, dude. They were never gay.
So he's James Charles?
Basically, polygamist? He's James Charles.
He's a redneck polygamist James Charles.
Exactly. He, like, influenced these guys... There's one part. Okay, we might have to bleep this out because it's kind of inappropriate, and I don't know how our listeners will like this. But he's like, there's like this guy, one of his husbands. So this is literally how it goes, dude. He's like, it's this guy right here. He's like this teenage kid, and he comes to the farm or whatever, and
farm
and to the farm, and Joe's like, hey, are you straight? And the kid's like, yeah, I'm straight. I'm not gay at all. And Joe's just like,
not anymore.
And Joe's just like, basically, dude, Joe's just like, do you the guy with the or the he's like, well, obviously, like, well, you're not that gay or you're not that straight then. And then literally cuts to this, bro. It cuts to their wedding, their polygamous wedding right after that. He's like, oh, you're not so straight then. And then, bum, bum, ba-da. It's so good, dude. He just convinced these guys that they were gay somehow. Which, dude, you gotta be so retarded.
I think churches need, like, the opposite of him. Because isn't that what they're trying to do? Is convert people, but they're trying to convert them the other way?
There's two ends of the spectrum. There's Joe Exotic, and then there's this other dude. And he's gotta be working for the church, the freaking Christians, bro. For people to not be gay. That's so dope. But, yeah, dude, that's his husband, John. But then, oh, dude, every episode, it just gets darker and darker. It's so bad. Like, by the end, it's like a twisted freaking thing. Like, this kid...
It sounds twisted enough already.
This kid shoots himself in the head.
What?
Dude, it's so crazy, bro. It's so bad. But, and okay, so... So, this is not funny at all, but it's actually really funny. So, the kid, his husband kills himself because Joe is, like, insane. And so... Then they're at the funeral for the kid, and Joe's giving this big, like, pretty inappropriate speech, and then immediately after, oh, shoot, I never even said, dude, he makes country music.
What?
Forgot to say that. We gotta watch this video, okay? This isn't even an option,
well,
bro.
Okay, well, then we gotta continue the story after this, because now you got me, like just started
bro, I just
on a cliffhanger.
I had to introduce this freaking story, bro, so let's just, normally I'm not a fan of country music, but, bro, this is just something else, bro. Can't watch this video, dude. This is about saving tigers from hunters, bro. Just vibe to this one.
Tell all the hunters to lay down their
guns. Are you hunting with like an AK-47 or?
Tell them that the tiger needs a little bit of love.
I mean, it actually sounds pretty good, though.
Oh, but that's not him singing, though. That's not... None of this is his music.
Or
he claimed it to be his music, but I'm pretty sure, like, it's confirmed that this is not him. If you've ever heard his voice, dude, there's no way he sings like that.
Yeah, I can't hear gay redneck sounding like that.
And look at this voice, literally, like, green screen.
What?
Onto a green screen. Onto a green screen. Onto a green screen, dude. That's four green screens. That's so awesome, bro.
I can give him a home.
Oh my gosh, dude. I hope we don't get copyrighted for this. I have no idea what the copyright is.
Yeah, I don't know.
So funny. I don't care. So he's a country singer, and so he tells this big long inappropriate story at his husband's freaking funeral, and then he immediately just starts singing his country music, dude. Just for the entire funeral, and he's like jamming, and it's the most awkward thing I've
that
ever
is
watched, bro.
So weird.
It's so crazily awkward.
Okay, well, should we get back to that story? Is that what wait,
that, was,
that, oh,
that was?
That was
the end
okay.
of the story. Yeah,
I'm
funeral,
just making sure because
at the funeral, he starts singing his country music for everybody, and he's really like a. I just want to pull up a video of him talking, dude. I wish I could freehand this because I can't really type that fast with one hand. Joe Exotic. We're just gonna look him up. Oh gosh, dang it, dude! He has so much good stuff. So much good stuff. Oh, is
Joe
this
Exotic
his?
For president?
Oh, dude, this is his
professional logo
gosh,
for your
Wix,
brand.
Bro.
I've used the new Wix logo maker
Wix
to create
ads.
One for my
can you
startup.
Stop advertising you. Wix.
I'm Joe Exotic, and today this is not going out to any kind of a presidential candidate
this was
or any politician of the purpose of this video today. He should let you know who I am. First thing is, I am not cutting my hair. I'm not changing the way I dress. I refuse to wear a suit. I am gay. I've had two boyfriends most of my life. I currently got legally married. Thank God. It's finally legal in America. I've had some kinky sex. I have tried drugs through the younger years of my life. I am broke as I have a judgment against me from some down there in Florida. But I can tell you, I paid a fine with the USDA, and that is nothing but a civil fine, ladies and gentlemen. That does not mean that I was accused or convicted of any kind of animal cruelty thing. I built one of the biggest facilities and the nicest facilities for exotic animals in this country as far as a private individual goes. I'm Joe Exotic, and don't forget, I am now stepping my foot in the ring to run for president. And this is all paid for by the committee of Joe Exotic, speaks for America.
Why?
Yes!
Why wouldn't you vote for it?
Oh, if he came back, if he ran again from prison, he would win. If it came down to him and Trump, dude, who would win? Honestly? Trump or this gay redneck that's in prison for attempted murder? That's what I want to know.
I don't know. It sounds pretty close.
I want to see that battle, bro.
Does he actually think that's going to like win people over, though? He's like,
he was
broke
dead
as heck.
So he didn't win the presidency, obviously, because we just read Donald Trump's tweet. But then he ran for governor of whatever state he's from. I don't even remember.
Isn't it like Florida. Louisiana?
I don't know if it was. It might have been Louisiana.
No, it's Arkansas, like I think my mom said.
I was not paying attention. I know it's not Florida. That's all I know, it's not Florida. Because I was very surprised when I found out it was not Florida.
So, well, because you just see the Florida Man headlines everywhere.
Yeah,
so it's
yeah
like,
dude,
it's gotta be.
Dude, Joe Exotic is Florida Man.
He totally
is. That's what he is. He is Florida Man.
Like, Florida Man outside of Florida.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Dude, it's kinda, like, if, like in the news when it says Florida Man, it's like Joe Exotic. That's who it is, you know? Anyways, dude. Go watch Tiger King, please, bro. It's so good.
If you thought of Florida episodes as a person, it would be Joe Exotic.
Yeah. Florida as a personified being. Joe Exotic, bro. I'm Joe Exotic. Dude, I thought I was going to bring something else up, but I can't. Oh, there's a dude in that, and he's like, the most level-headed one of the entire show. He's like a producer. He produced a reality show for Joe Exotic. He filmed a whole reality show, but it all got burned to the ground. Long story. And he talks like this the whole time. And I'm like, oh, dude, that's the coolest voice I've ever heard. Anyways, that's really funny. Woo! All right, bro. Okay, dude, I saw this video. I saw this video in my recommended. Dude, YouTube recommended keeps on blessing us over here.
Oh, yeah.
Bro,
so
YouTube
good
recommended.
That's how I saw the men's bathroom choir. That changed my life.
Bro, we got... Check this out, dude.
This is going to be like one of those
it's
My
like
Strange
TLC
Addiction.
Yeah, dude. Literally, this whole channel is like kind of a TLC sort of vibe.
Oh, great.
But anyway, so I saw this in my recommended. It says, this woman lives every day like it's 1958. And I was very intrigued. And so I watched the entire thing 8 times. And here we go.
I'm Lacey Faye, and I live every day like it's 1958. People's reaction is, it's almost always positive. This is who I am. This is what I like and I feel like. You should do what you like. You should do what makes you feel beautiful and dress however you want to dress.
Dude, her hair right now, okay, just, it looks like somebody put her into Photoshop and was trying to cut an outline and accidentally just lopped off half of her hair.
Oh my gosh, it totally does.
Like, lopped off most of her hair trying to make a thumbnail for YouTube or something, dude. What is going on? Oh, it's so good.
You feel the most like you.
People will stop dead in their tracks and they'll just stop and their eyes are fixed on her as we'll walk by.
Yeah. Hey,
wonder
hey,
why.
I'll give you a hint as to why, bro. Hey, I'll give you a hint as to why, dude. It's because she's dressed like she's from 1958, okay?
Yeah. It's not because you have a super hot wife.
It's not because she's you.
One place in town that kind of brings in the 1950s vibe quite well is the local pharmacy. It's called Bullet Drug, and they have a soda fountain, they have a jukebox. It makes it a lot of fun.
Chocolate sundae?
Let's do it.
Okay, dude, this is... I was wondering when I was watching this, do you think... This is such a bad joke, but do you think he beats her if she doesn't clean the kitchen like they did in 1958? Do you, though? Dude, they live like it's 1958, bro.
I mean, you gotta be with the times, dude.
Exactly,
whatever
man
time you're living in, you just gotta be with the times.
What do you think... Hey, what do you think they do for... How do they pay for this ice cream sundae, dude? What do you think they do for jobs?
Drop a couple nickels on the counter. Yeah.
they just scrounge for nickels. Bro, but like...
Like, I'm sorry, inflation, it was way different in 1958. Like, we can get this for way cheaper.
Dude, imagine them going into, like, a job interview, and she just walks in, and she just perches down, and the guy's just like, I think I've seen all I need to see. How could they have a job? How could you show up to work looking like that, bro? That's... Dude, the funniest part comes later, bro. Just hold on a second. So I got some nice subs, bro.
Hey, As soon as I put on the first 1950s dress with my hair and makeup done, that's when I felt like I was finally me. That's found my authentic self, and I've never looked back since then. I really honed in on the 1950s because of my grandparents. They got married in 1955, and their stories, it just made it sound like the best time ever. Everything's beautiful, colorful, happy, optimistic.
Vietnam was about to start in full swing.
And there was
Jim Crow laws were going on.
People were beating each other in the streets because of race. There was no cure for polio. Nixon, I don't know when he was president, but Watergate, you know. Mm-hmm. The works, bro.
Built 1953. So we've tried to pack as much in as we can while keeping it authentic. I don't want it to look like it's a 50s museum. I want it to look like it's an authentic 1950s home that you've walked into.
Oh my gosh.
When people walk into our house for the first time, a smile comes on everybody's face.
So he says a smile comes on everybody's face.
It's probably one of those, like, I'm trying to hold back a laugh.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was going to say, dude. This is what the smile is. This is what I picture, dude. It's the smile where somebody, like, says something or does something that you don't necessarily agree with and you think they're kind of insane, but it's like, it's this smile. That's awesome, Jennifer.
Or
it's
just like,
oh, gosh, dude. Or they're just like, yeah, mm-hmm. Or they're just laughing because it's not, nope, if I walk into a house and it's decked out like the 1920s, I'm feeling insecure about my safety.
Yeah.
I don't feel safe in that house where the people
are insane
in the 1920s and insane.
Probably,
dude.
Possessed or something.
Straight up possessed by a 1920s demon, dude. And they're just doing the jitterbug in possessed bodies, bro. That's so dope. But yeah, that's these people, bro. Oblivious people, my favorite kind of people. Hands down, people that don't know that what they're doing or saying is wrong, and they just do it. They're my favorite people because they're so dumb, and it's so funny to watch, and they just don't understand. And yeah, that's kind of dope, though. They look like a cartoon. They look like a Barbie monster.
Our 1950s kitchen, I've tried to do as authentic as I could, and I think the appliances work better. It was built to last forever, but that you would keep that forever. And
So technology has not advanced at all?
Yeah, I mean,
things were actually better in the 50s, you know?
They were built to last. I'm pretty sure some of the 1950s and old stuff is, like, rusted and
yeah,
all
bro,
gone now.
Legit,
there's
hey.
Well, and, like, you have heard the thing where the technology that they used to put us on the moon, our phones are, like, 1,000 times more advanced than that. And that, the moon, that was before that even happened.
Yeah.
So what kind of technology do they think is going to be better than right now?
Basically, they're just saying, like, do you not think there's a reason that technology advances? It gets better, dude. Technology doesn't just advance just because, dude. It's because they discover new things and it gets better.
Mm-hmm. They're not just like, oh, we're just going to change this. It's probably going to be worse.
Oh, it's actually, the appliances are actually better. I actually just dug a hole in the wall and I just cooked my food in there like the Aztecs would have done in their tombs because it just cooks it to perfection, you know? This modern technology is just not as good as what the Persians would have done, you know? Back when Jesus was alive, man.
I think so. I mean, a fridge's been running for 70 years. It's fine. It's not stopped
crazy.
Yet.
It's crazy.
The only room that's not decorated 50s is my son.
Did you see that man's face? Oh, honey, these are delicious.
Yeah. It took him a second to, like, get that smile on his face. He had to, like, react to the cookie
first. It's like
first,
someone's holding,
like,
a gun behind the camera, just, like, up to his head. Just, yeah. You don't like this.
Good, honey.
That was probably like the fifth time they did that shot until he could finally smile the first time.
He just couldn't get a smile.
He could taste like the all the other food that's been on the
rust and oh the disgusting the ashes, bro. That's disgusting.
So we let him choose.
This it feels so part. Normal to me now that I wouldn't really think of it as different anymore. When we first
that's
moved into the
son,
house,
bro.
And started getting more.
They have oh a kid, gosh. Dude, and he's just living his life, dude.
I feel bad for him. Oh
yeah.
God. Imagine, like, wanting to call your homies over and they pull up to your house to play some Xbox and you got a 1950s TV.
Are their kids, like, not allowed to play Xbox or anything? They can't do anything that's, like,
bro, that
not
looks like modern. So he's just, like,
At what age was he like, hey, mom, dad, I don't want to do this anymore.
It's like coming out of the closet. I don't want to live in the 1950s.
Mom, dad, I can't do this. I can't do this anymore. I can't keep living this lie. Son, what do you mean? Mom, dad, I know this is, you guys are not going to be very proud of me. I just hope that you'll continue to love me after this. Son, you can tell us anything. I don't want to live like we're in 1958 anymore. Get out! Get out! Get out of the house! Connor, leave! That's so funny, dude. Oh my gosh. Bro, literally, just imagine. Just like, so, Connor, what do your parents do? They live every day like it's 1958. What was that? What was that, Connor? They live every day like they're in 1958? Oh. Okay, Connor. We're not talking to you anymore. Dude, this kid probably gets so bullied.
Yeah.
I feel so bad, dude. Imagine your parents. I bet his room is all decked out in, like, normal stuff. And he's just, like, he's just living a whole separate.
Well, he's wearing normal clothes.
Yeah, dude. He's
like, chill on the couch while the parents are, like, watching, like, satellite TV and trying to connect the antennas.
No, dude, they just don't let him in.
He's on his phone, chilling.
Like. Bro, the only way he can be allowed into the living room is if he's wearing the appropriate attire, dude.
Yeah.
Connor, don't step foot in the kitchen until you have your bow tie and tux on, Connor. Until you have your hair slicked back and your button-up shirt on. Oh, dude. Yeah, poor kid. Listen, dude.
Objects secondhand. I always thought that was kind of weird, but it just got to be so normal, and now it's, like, fun. You go to the thrift store and find something like fun, that just makes our house
It's like
perfect.
We play dress-up every day.
I used to think it was, like, kind of weird, but now it's kind of like fun.
Do you think that it was like when he was little, he thought his parents were putting on an act for him, and he's like, okay, mom and dad, you can stop it now. Like, the act doesn't need to keep going on.
I just want to know, like, what age he just realized, hey, this is not a normal thing to be doing, dude. Like, that's so awesome.
He goes outside and people are normal. Like,
mom and dad, what are those things those people are holding? Oh, those are iPhones. They're of the devil. They do not remind us of a simpler time.
Mom, why can I see that guy's calves? Oh, those are shorts.
Why can I see that guy's calves, dude? Mom, dude, do they use the internet, do you think?
I don't think they would, but I don't know.
But how do they do their taxes?
They probably
tax
have
fraud.
Like
they don't pay taxes.
Yeah. Taxes just like the good old days.
they just do it all by paper and everything.
They can't use
and
freaking TurboTax, bro. That's not 1958. They gotta like look something up. They gotta go down to the local library. Encyclopedias, bro. Mom, dad, I got a question. I don't know where I was going with that. Anyways,
this front section is true vintage. One of my favorite ones. I just barely found a couple of months ago, and it's actually like an early 50s, late 40s. Another one of my favorites is this one, and I love it because it was given to me by the original owner.
Girls wear clothes like that nowadays.
Yeah, that's not like, there's some.
To me, the 1950s style is normal. I understand that to outside folks looking in, that it could be weird, but I think everybody's weird. In their own way, everybody's nerdy about something, and it might as well be something that you love.
It doesn't affect their whole life.
Hey, listen to me. I like Star Wars a little bit, okay? I think Star Wars is a fine thing.
Mm-hmm. But you don't live in Star Wars.
But I don't dress up like Darth Vader and go in public and drive the Millennium Falcon, dude. That's not
Although
something
that
to
would
do.
Be pretty cool.
That would be awesome.
But I don't because it's weird, dude. And you gotta conform to society. That's all I'm saying, man. Straight up conform.
We live in a society, dude.
That's so true, dude.
My unconventional life and my unconventional oven, dude. That's the title of this video. Oh, that's so dope.
Wow.
So yeah, I thought that was hilarious. But it just reminded me, dude, people just straight up need to stop trying to relive the past, you know? We got the whole future ahead of us, you know?
We got like a whole pandemic to look forward to.
We got a whole pandemic. We're isolated. We're quarantined. Dude, we got so much to look forward to. Our country, our economy is in the garbage, and it's okay, dude. It's okay.
Like, we're probably going to be in another 1920s, 1930s situation.
Yeah,
we're just going to go to the Great Depression pretty soon.
She might get a wish. We'll go through a depression, have to freaking fend for ourselves, and she'll be chilling.
And then we'll go into a war.
And then we'll go into a freaking war with Vietnam.
Oh.
Dude, that's so dope. Oh my gosh. Oh man. That's all I had. That's all I had in my notes, fellas.
I want you to have a pandemic counter when this video goes up.
Pandemic.
Every time Brock or anyone says pandemic.
Dude, that's
pandemic.
I said pandemic a lot.
You do say pandemic a lot. Pandemic. We should just like start putting pandemic into our everyday sentences just in random spots.
Hey man, you want to go down by the car wash and get a pandemic car wash? I don't even know, dude. Dude, I don't even know.
Worst thing I've ever heard in my life. You just use it as like an adjective. You just describe stuff with it. Like,
hey, you want to go down and ride the pandemic?
go ride the pandemic. Bro, that's pandemic, bro. This party is so pandemic, bro. This freaking party is pan, bro. Pandemic, dog. I hate people. So
you need to start using that, dude.
People are awful, dude. I hate people. Oh man. Anyways, I got so much homework to do, dude. We better wrap this up, bro. I got an hour to do it, so I can wake up in the morning, dude. I woke up this morning to run at like 6 a.m, and I woke up, and the wind was howling so loud. Yeah. And I looked, and it was blowing 20 miles an hour at 6 a.m, bro. Mm-hmm. That's terrible.
Yeah, and I probably got to go to bed. I'm running a mile time trial in the morning, or sometime tomorrow. I don't even know
when. Time trial?
It's basically a race without any other people, so it's going to be fun.
So you're just trying to beat your own record?
Yeah.
That's dope.
Because I've got nothing else to do, so, you know.
Look, man, we got to fill our time with stuff, dude. We got to fill our time. We got to figure out what we like to do, and we got to do it, man. That's the way we get through this, and we get through this together, too, man, you know? And next time I'm going to have my Ultra Boosts, and I'm doing the whole podcast like this so I can show off my Ultra Boost DNAs for you guys.
Should I wear my Ultra Boost that I've, like, totally destroyed? Because I've been running in my Ultra Boost for, like, a year, so.
We'll share the space for our Ultra Boost, man.
Sweet, Davis, you need to get in the club.
I'll buy some Ultra Boosts, bro. Get some boosts. Anyways, dude, I'm so tired. I've been yelling this whole time. I'm so sleepy.
You have been yelling this whole time.
Okay, thanks for listening, guys. Review this podcast right now. Like it, share it with somebody. Dude, we got to grow this KG army here. And now we got, like, it's like this podcast army, but it's also, it's the KG army, too. It's pretty much the KG army, bro.
Pretty much, yeah.
Pretty much the KG army. You can be a general if you want. If you share this, you're a corporal of the KG army.
Smash the like button.
Smash like, bro. Leave a comment. Literally, though, share this, bro. Or... if you're not in it, dude, if you're not in this for the long haul, dude, if you're like, if this is like one of those parties where you're like, yeah, I'll go and like, I'll feel it out for a couple of minutes and like, I'll probably leave in like half an hour. This is that for you. Take a hike, dude.
Now's your time to leave.
Bro, put on some freaking Solomons and a backpack and take a hike, bro. Oh my gosh. Get out of town and take a hike. We don't want you. But if you're in this for the long haul, you're a corporal of the KG army, dude. You're going to make your way to general. I don't know. You're a private. What's the rankings?
I don't know. I have no freaking clue. Tenderfoot. I'm just
Tenderfoot. You could be a first-class Eagle Scout, bro.
We need Private Staley up in here.
Yeah, we're going to get Private Staley on
dude,
the podcast.
Dude, we do need Private Staley.
Days, dude. One of these days. Oh, dude, I want to get so many people on the show. This is so fun. I love doing podcasts.
Anyways, it was a blast. Thanks for having me out here.
Dude, yeah, thank you for being on. Hey, and our video ended right when we were gonna end. Yes, dude.
Let's go.
Yes, dude. Yes. I love when this happens.
You just
dude.
Slammed
how,
the mic
how
down.
Are my I ears still getting raped and you don't even happens. Have a microphone?
Dude,
I don't
I
get it.
I love when this happens when we're about to end the podcast and all of a sudden my camera's just like, nope, dude. That's so awesome. Dude, life is so good. Can I just say that right now? Oh, life is just the best.
Your camera loves you, Brock.
Life is so good, dude. Oh
especially right now. It's just getting better and better every day.
Every single minute.
Because of this
for me.
Pandemic.
Because pandemic, dude.
Dude, life is just pandemic right now.
Okay, but dude, this podcast is so pandemic, bro. This podcast is pan, bro.
You just gotta call it pandemic. This podcast name is pandemic.
Pandemic, bro?
Yes.
I gotta, dude, we gotta start writing down something.
We still have to put the Trump. How can we combine all of that?
Trump's pandemic.
Trump's
a major pandemic.
A pandemic petition for Trump
No, dude.
I don't know how to word this.
The episode like petition to end all petitions or something.
Petition to end all petitions except for the petition to petition.
It can't be too long though, dude. It's got to be catchy, catchy, clever. Petition to end all
petitions. Petition to end all petitions petition that are not pandemic.
Petition to end corona. Bro, I remember the first day, like, when everything started getting canceled, I was trying to go to a movie, and it got canceled, and it really pissed me off, and I said I was going to kill the CEO of coronavirus.
Oh my gosh.
I thought that was really funny, dude. Anyways. Yeah, we got to get out of here, dude. I'm so behind on so much schoolwork, bro.
Yeah, same. We've surpassed the hour mark.
Heck yeah, dude. Thanks for listening, guys. Love you. Check out all the rest of our podcasts. Davis, do you have anything you want to plug, like your social media? Nobody watches this anyways, but yeah. You can go ahead. Yeah, whatever. All right, see you guys. Love you.
Yeah, don't follow me on social media. I don't want you to follow me.
So. I'm actually back on social media. I took a break for a while because I had a panic attack, but I'm back, bro. So go follow all my shiz. Outro, baby. Let's go.
We out.
Let's get jiggy with it, baby.
Yeah. Ooh.